Hey guys, this is Venom3421 and welcome to my new playthrough. It's a PS2 game. It's one of my favorites. Haven't played this in so long. You'll see what it is pretty soon. Yep, right here. Yep. This is Jak and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy. And I'm recording this in my room, so I usually record the big stuff, the PS3 stuff, in my living room. So. And here's the title. Yep. I don't know how long it's been. Is it like 4 years? I don't know. Oh, I erased the memory. Okay, never mind. Let's create a new game, shall we? Yeah, I probably forgot where everything is. Maybe. I don't know. Might remember a few, but nah. But I do remember some of the controls. I don't know how long it's been. Like I said, probably 4 or 5 years. I don't know. I should start playing some games that I haven't played in a while. You know, like Shaolin Monks. That kind of stuff. Here we go. Let's use this one. Okay, I'm going to shut up now during the cutscenes.
I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that litter our planet? How did they harness eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy, oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of green ego, one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Hey! Jack, old green stuff told us not to come here.
Disobeyed. That's not good. Anyway, you haven't gathered. These are the two protagonists, Jak and Daxter, obviously. And who was this now? These are the two antagonists, right there.
Continue your search for artifacts and eco. Those precursor items, you know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it.
Looks like we have been noticed.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps. Huh? Wow, stupid precursor junk. Ick! What is that, Doc? Ooh! It sure doesn't look friendly. The Sage yaks on about the precursor that built this place all the time. Where did they go? Why did they build this crust? Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble!
And here comes the birth of the real Daxter, right there.
Where is that stone? I told you we shouldn't have come here, and you listened! What? Okay. I'm fine.
You can see the look at Jack's face. Yeah.
What in green tarnation do you two want?
We were...
Don't tell me! Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around at the only place that I told you not to go. Misty Island.
That's right! And then...
And, Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark eco.
What, old man? Are you gonna keep yapping? Are you gonna have to yap again?
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied Dark Eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Karl Acheron, the Sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages. I would teleport you there, but I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while. The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it if you had a door equipped with a heat shield. I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment. All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira, that might work. But where are a boy and a half going to get 20 power cells?
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wild, just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer, at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better go through the warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark gooey eco stuff, will we? Because I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there before I turn you both into ferns.
Well, let's not. We don't want it to become a plant, do we? No, we don't. Well, anyway, tutorial time. Okay.
Advice is a communicator. With it, my father and I can give you advice at any time during your quest.
Jesus, it's been a long time. I forgot the camera. Okay, left. Yeah, anyway. Basically, well.
You can't come back to the warp gate until you find all four power cells on this island.
Okay, obviously this is where you... This is moving, obviously. Jump. Double jump. Spin. What else is there? Crouch. High jump. Well, to do a high jump, you have to crouch first, then go like that. You know. Pressing L1 while moving. You roll. But you do like a... If you press X while rolling, you do a long jump, like that. And jump, press punch, you do a dive attack. You'll spin, you know. So, yeah, tutorial. Here we go. I'm not much of a talker during these. Okay.
Precursor orbs. Collect enough of them, and some of the
villagers
will give you a power cell in exchange.
Oh, just to let you guys know, I am ME400%, meaning all precursor orbs, all power cells, all that. But I'm gonna have trouble finding it because I haven't played this game in like since when I was young, obviously. Alright, let's wait on a sec.
It's a power cell, the most important precursor artifact you can find. You need to collect 20 of these so I can power the heat shield for your A-glass zoomer.
Yeah. These things are important, like she said. You can't progress without them, so you need to collect them. And of course, memory card stuff, blah blah blah. Yeah, it saves. We know, game, we know. Yeah, dummies. Lurker dummies. You don't need to destroy them all. Okay, these things are also important to me right here. So let's collect some eco right here. Yeah, scout flies. They're inside these boxes in here. You need to collect all 7 in each area in order to get a power cell. Important. If you want to go for 100%. You don't have to if you don't want to, but in order to progress this Sandover Village, you have to collect at least 20. Door to progress. And we got our second power cell.
Wow! That last scout flight had a power cell! I'll bet if you collect all 7 in each area, you can find even more power cells!
Yeah. You know, now, like I said, you need 20 power cells in order to progress. If you don't have 20, then you can't progress yet, and you have to find more. And also, I'll explain the precursor orbs in a second. I just want to do this. I'm not going to explain what that is. I'm going to let Samos explain what these lightning stuff was.
Blue eco, which contains the energy of motion. Blue eco allows you to run fast, break boxes, and even activate some precursor artifacts when you get near them.
Yeah, blue eco makes you run fast, break nearby objects, and unlock stuff with it. It also make the power cell come to you, and green eco come to you.
How each blue eco cluster you pick up increases the time you can use its power.
Yeah.
This is a precursor door. It can only be opened by approaching the door while channeling blue eco through your body.
Yeah. Doors like this, if it has like a blue lightning symbol, like right here, you'll see. Well, stupid camera. Yeah, whatever. You need blue eco in order to open that door.
That's a blue eco vent. More concentrated than the floating clusters. This vent will give you a full charge of blue eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
That's useful. These vents will give you, full powered eco. So here we go. We need that to open the door. Here's the blue eco. Not blue, wait, the blue eco? No, power cell. Sorry.
Good work. The blue eco caused the door to open. With blue eco, you can breathe energy into all kinds of precursor artifacts that have lain dormant for years.
I am not used to the controls. Maybe once I play this game more, I'll get used to it again. I'm a little rusty.
Those little green balls of energy on the ground are a type of eco. Pick up 50 small green ecos or one big green one to increase your health.
Health is always good. Well, all games' health is always good. Well, games like this. Yeah, green eco equals health, so.
You can jump once, then jump again in the air to reach even higher ledges.
And as you can see, we got all 50 precursor orbs in Geyser Rock, which is good. Flex those muscles, Daxter. Okay, anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. Next time, we get to explore Sandover Village and find more power cells in order to progress and stuff.